नमस्कार, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल, वेरी गुड इवनिंग लेडीज एंड जेंटलमैन। टुडे वी हैव एकता सहगल मल्होत्रा। यू ऑल मस्ट बी फेमिलियर बाय दिस नेम एट GWC। शी इज द फाउंडर मेंटर फॉर मानस मैनेजमेंट एडवाइजर्स, MQ, किडो मेंटरिंग एंड वानस क्राफ्ट। शी इज ऑल्सो मैनेजिंग वानस क्राफ्ट एंड किडो मेंटरिंग अलॉन्ग विथ MQ। She'll be telling more about these ventures later. But let me start this interaction with her by stating these lines of Audrey Hepburn. Nothing is impossible in this world. The word impossible itself says, I am possible. Whatever you think, you can always achieve that. And we have a living example in front of us today. So I would like to welcome Ekta Sehgal Malhotra, founder and curator for Manas Management Advisors, MQ, Kiddo Mentoring, and Vanyas Craft. Welcome, Ekta.
Thank you, Akansha. Very well, thank you. And to be on a platform where you spearhead that as a president, it's indeed an honor and privilege. And being a talk show host myself, but when you become the guest, it definitely, makes your hand and feet go cold. And that too in a cold, winter evening in December. So thank you so much for this respect and honor.
Pleasure. Pleasure is all ours. So you already know, ladies, when she's here in this talk show, it means she aspires to inspire. And she is here because we want you all to get inspired from her story, from the journey that she has lived through, the struggles, the challenges that she faced, and how she overcome those challenges. So she is here, the living example of a wonderful life that she created for herself. So let's start with the questions. All the ladies, I would request you all, once we are going through this interaction, if you have any question regarding any of the ventures of Ekta, or probably the way she handled the struggles, you can always post these questions and we are able to see these questions and we'll definitely ask her. So Ekta, before we move ahead to know more about you, I would like to know more about the very first job of yours and what was the domain for that job.
Right. So, Akansha, you actually taking me back almost 19 and a half years. That's the first love, the first job, the first time you see your child, the first time you get married. These are all very special moments and you never forget them. So, like everybody, my job was through campus placement in the year 2000 and I joined in 2001. And that was the year when the financial industry had very few jobs. And I was a little fussy about what I want to do. I didn't want to just take up a job because I was passing out from my management college. So this organization came to another college campus. And what I liked about this organization was that the chairman of this company comes from one of the richest family in our country. And he had no qualms about himself, and so much so that when he introduced himself, he only stuck to his first name. Until we were through with the entire interview proceeds, only then did we know that he comes from the richest family of our country, which is the Ambani family. Oh, wow. And when I got to know that, I was like, totally in awe of my boss then, because he was also the chairman of the company and also my direct boss. So when I started working, my first experience was a meeting with him, which I had about a week before I joined. And he gave me half an hour undivided attention. He told his secretary that I do not want any phone calls. And that was my first experience into the corporate world, that if you give time to someone, wow, and if you're committed to someone, give that person the undivided attention, because that person has also taken out time for you.
Lovely.
And that lesson has stayed with me. barring that, I think that was the learning ground for a management trainee. And I was exposed to every field, which actually helped me to set up my entrepreneur businesses. And I learned it all from there. So I really owe it to my first job and to this gentleman whose name I really want to take, Mr. Vipul Ambani. If you ever get to see this, I owe it all to you. And I always say this, that you have been that guide, mentor, philosopher, a very good friend. And he's really, he's a gem of a person.
Amazing. We always say the first impression is the last impression. So ladies, make sure how you create a first impression, because see how this gentleman has impacted Ekta's life, and now Ekta is there inspiring all of us. So Ekta, next question, a bit interesting, and we would definitely like to know more about it. Have you always been entrepreneurial, or and what led you to taking that first step and setting up your own business?
So Kancha, well, of course, you know, when you come from a service class family, my father was in the army, my mom was a teacher, and then she became a homemaker, but though she had some creative traits in her. But I remember, I think I was in class 8 or 9, having made a business plan, which my brother had also helped me. We made a business plan for a creche, because my mom was very fond of small children, and so was I. So we made a business model, and that I further developed in my post-grad. We had another assignment. So that is where I think somewhere the, you know, that kira, the bug had entered my mind. But it was just on paper. Nothing really, you know, was formalized. And then I started working. But over the years of working, you know, I realized that most organizations start at a very good note. But the moment they reach a point where they start getting pressured by the numbers, by revenue, that is where the ideology start to shake. And the foundation that is, you know, on which they build the organization, that starts to shake. Absolutely. And yeah, and the line of work that I come from, which is investments, where money is involved, trust really plays a very important role. And we've been brought up with a lot of value system in us, and honesty, you know, building that trust, building that bond with someone has been drilled in us. And I remember my father used to always tell me that at times we say lies, you know, for small gains or for immediate gains, but in the long run, it is only honesty that pays. So he made me understand that you have to, one, believe that never give up, and second, always say that a spade is a spade, no matter what. You're not here to please people. You know, you are here to do something which is right. So stick to that, and you will always achieve.
Absolutely. Wonderful. So the next question that we would like to know is, as a woman entrepreneur, because since you have so many responsibilities, you have to wear so many hats, being a mom, a womanpreneur, a wife, and so many things, so many relations that you have to take care of. So if any, were there any challenges that you experienced as a woman during your overall entrepreneurship journey?
Yes and no, because why I would say yes is that being a woman itself is a challenge, and more so in our country. And if the woman is headstrong, is very vocal, doesn't mince word, she definitely is viewed as a woman who's very intimidating and very overwhelming. So that was the kind of resistance I would experience. And since my line of work is a work which is predominantly dominated by men, be it the people who do either financial planning or are into the distribution of financial products, or the investors. So that was a strong resistance. And my reply to that, if I'm allowed to share that, is that I started my mentoring program exclusively for women, and started to break the myth that, one, money and investment is not a man's world. Because it is a lady of the house who does all the budgeting. It is she who manages it all, whether the man gets this much or this much. you know, she is the one who actually gets it rolling. So if she's the one, then how can it be a man's world? The other challenges that one would face is, I won't say that challenge was faced by men, but that challenge was faced by more women. That beautiful women always have an advantage over just about okay looking women. So as an entrepreneur, I feel that if you're good at your work precedes you. It doesn't matter how you look, how tall, short, ugly, beautiful you are. And those resistance are more in the mind. And unless the mindset of the people change, these resistance will come. And I think they are part and parcel of you growing up and you maturing to be able to deal with the situation. And whenever that comes in, my father's words always remind me, never give up. And my mother's determination stands tall with me that it's okay. You have to, you know, get over this no matter what, and just stick by it and you will achieve what you want to.
Definitely. Beautiful lines that can inspire anyone. So the next important question that we have is when we talk about finance. So women are, majority of the women, I would say, not all, exceptions are always there like you, but majority of the women, they are scared to manage finances. So we have many women who are homepreneurs, the women who are working from home, the women who go out for their businesses, who do a lot of meeting. But ultimately, the things that I get to hear and we get to hear is the finances are being managed by their spouses. I mean, the husbands, right, the male parts. So I just want to want you to throw some light on that, how important it is to understand the financial education in order to grow your business. Because as a womanpreneur, when you're starting something, you ought to have that information, you ought to have that education about finance and entrepreneurship.
Okay. I'm going to answer this in a little different way. Women, whether she's a homemaker, whether she's a womanpreneur, or whatever hat she wears, she goes and buys vegetables. Right? And she goes and buys a lot of other things also. And she knows how to negotiate. What does she negotiate basis? The knowledge that she has about how much the vegetable will cost, and when, and basic logic that she uses, you know, the value against what she's getting. So if that be the case, then how can it be that finance is so complicated? Finance is very easy to understand. It is important for women that if you really, really want to empower yourself, because empowering means not being overly liberated, but empowering means to educate yourself, to enhance your knowledge. And if you want to really empower yourself, you do your own investments. You have to manage your finances, because if that is one area where you do not pay attention, you are not a successful businesswoman. Think about it. Do men come to you and ask you, how do I manage the aesthetics of my business? How do I define my brand logos? How do I dress up for a business meeting? Well, husband and wife do talk about these things, but I don't think he's going to ask you, should I wear this tie or should I wear a pocket square? So if it is as simple as that, because investment is all logic. And also, Akansha, you know, it is, we've discussed it on the GWC platform earlier also. You know, these books, Men Are From Mars and Women Are From Venus, and it's a man's world. Women don't understand math. They cannot be engineers. You know, all these cliches are being drilled. That stereotyping has to break for people to understand. And believe me, ladies, for all of you who are hearing or who would hear this at a later point in time, investments of finance is basic common sense. There is no rocket science to it. Sit down with it. Then you will be, if you can manage your expense, all you have to do is just take one step ahead and you're sorted. And I think, you know, women are nurturer. They are long-term thinkers and they have patience, because, you know, as a mother or as a lady, you know, you do so many things, you multitask. So you learn all these things. So these virtues come very naturally to you. If these virtues come so naturally, why do you shy away from using that those virtues in you and just add a little bit of acumen and knowledge and you're empowered.
True. Absolutely.
That's what I would say.
So, for your information, the people who are watching us, Ita runs a women-oriented mentoring session, especially in finance. So you may connect to her, and definitely she's going to help you out, because it's better that you try and begin this finance part to grow your business. So the very important question now for Ekta is, since you are managing so many ventures, so what do you think, what are the characteristics, values or skills as the founder, director of a business?
One is passion.
True.
The other is perseverance. And the third is panache. The three P's which will lead you to be educated, empowered, and enlightened. So these three P's and these three E's, along with three C's, which is communication, communication, and communication. When you will combine all these, you will be able to achieve all that you want to. Because then people will perceive you as someone who believes in oneself, who believes in what they do, and you will never get impacted by that failure, because that failure to a lot of people may be failure, but for you, it is a stepping stone to success. And also I feel that, you know, when women run a business setup or are a professional, they should always remember that alone, nobody can reach the top. You always need those helping hands. You always need those railings to hold on to be able to reach on the top. Because, you know, as you go on the incline, it is difficult to go without a stake or a railing. So your fellow women, preneurs, or whoever walks your path, they are the ones who help you. So never forget to actually work hand in hand, and then you will always succeed, because they will be there to support you when you are about to tilt, or you need that little push to walk up that elevated pitch.
Absolutely. Wonderful. Beautiful lines again. The next question that we have for you is, were there some make or break moments in your entrepreneurship journey? Like sometimes it happens with me also, and since we go through so many stories, we find that one moment can make them rise and one moment can make them break. So were there any such moments in your life?
Yeah, I'm normal. I'm a normal human being, and I go through all those emotions that anybody else would go through. So my first make or break moment, Akansha, was not during my entrepreneur journey, but was while I was still working in the corporate world. And it was a decision that I had to take to move from Mumbai to Delhi when my father was unwell. And it was a tough decision, not because I wanted to, you know, be with my parents, but as a professional, I was at the peak of my career. And, you know, if I had to term myself as the queen of the world. And I was doing exceptionally well, and Bombay is the place for my kind of a work, but I had to take that decision. And that instance taught me how to prioritize, that what is important and what is critical, you have to be very clear about it. And I moved back here. And the time that I moved here was not only a change of location, but the financial markets had crashed. And I really had to lift myself up. And so what I learned in that whole process is that never carry your baggage. Because the moment you keep on carrying that baggage, you will be burdened and you will always live on your past laurels. And from that day onwards, I started to create new highs for myself, new successes for myself, and I left the baggage on the side. Coming to the entrepreneurial journey, I guess, you know, many a times you do have those frustrating moments where you feel that, you know, what you're doing is not supported by the variables around you. But those are very momentary. They just come for a flash second when you're like really bugged, because the work is such that at times it is very, very frustrating, and the adrenaline rush is always very high. But barring that, I think it's been a very interesting roller coaster ride. And I would say that I have learned that every challenge that comes my way, if I can in some way or the other create it as an opportunity and see what I learn. And please, you know, these are not just words that I'm saying, but I genuinely mean when I say this, that many a times, you know, you get stuck with a client who just doesn't want to understand for whatever reasons. You know, it could be a man, it could be a woman. And those moments are more frustrating than anything else, because you know, it's the it's not the product that you're dealing with, it is not the system that you're dealing with, it is a human mind that you're dealing with. And businesses are all about human emotions, especially the one that I run. And to overcome the emotion of the other person, you have to control your emotions. So for me, what works is I take a step back, I calm myself down, I think from the other person's perspective that why is the person reacting like this? And then I, you know, I take my time off from it and I move to my other venture, because obviously, you know, one is very intellectual, the other is very artistic. So I move to the other one quickly. I calm myself down and I come back to the more intellectual one, so that the negative thought process that goes in my mind doesn't get impacted to the client. So these are the challenges, not those huge ones that say that, okay, I don't want to do it. Of course, you know, in the fit of the moment, you do say, many times I tell my husband, I'm done, I don't want to do this. But that's because there are many other factors that are playing around you. You're just tired and you're playing so many roles. But I think what gets me going is that, how do I do it better the next day? So like I said, you know, I go back that I'm doing this because it's my passion. And if I'm passionate about it, I will persevere towards it. And if I have to persevere, I have to have my exuberance levels back. And that's how I keep myself going.
That's so true. Amazing. When you were sharing this make or break moments, one question that popped in my mind is, being the founder director of so many ventures, is it difficult or not? Because managing 3 to 4 ventures,
not really. In fact, I think the year 2020 has been absolutely enriching in terms of knowledge, in terms of experience, in terms of any and everything that you may say. And I think what has really come handy again here is the values that were imbibed, that learn to be disciplined. So I you know, you already shared my profile, so most of them what I do. So I've slotted my days that, okay, this day is for this, this day is for this. And I, you know, since I do a lot of mentoring program where I talk about financial planning, where I talk about planning, strategizing, thinking about all those variables. So I use all of that for my own work also. So whatever I want to do in the coming month, say if I have to do something in January, by mid of December, my calendar or my thought process is already planned out for January. Of course, we do have fallouts where people may back out or whatever the case may be, but it's okay. So that becomes a free day for me.
Lovely.
So like I said, if you are passionate about something, you'll put your heart and soul into it. There are moments where, you know, I need to take a step back, because when I feel that it's getting too much, and that reflection is in my daughter, when she starts saying that, you know, don't take calls, don't attend calls, then I know that, okay, I need to take a step back. So now I have one full dedicated day for her where I don't do anything substantial. I spend more time with her. So that day is Vanya's day, because weekends are relatively busier. And so yeah, so she, you know, it's not Vanya's craft here, but it's Vanya's day. And, you know, then I plan out, I do some activity before. Yeah, so that's how I plan. So I think discipline and pre-planning really helps me manage all that I do.
Completely. I completely buy your point over here. So so this was all about entrepreneurship, and we were talking to a financial advisor too. But now I just want to know, as you were talking about Vanya, so as a mother, you ought to take a sabbatical in between. During those crucial years, you take a sabbatical for sure. So during that point of time, what was there in your mind about your venture, or what ideas popped in during that phase of your life? Because many women, they fall prey to postpartum depression.
Yeah. So there was no such thing as maternity leave for me. And there was no such thing as a sabbatical for me. In fact, what I would term is that during my pregnancy, the Vimentoring, was born then. I did my maximum number of Vimentoring programs during 2016 when I had conceived. In fact, I think my first session, the day I had closed it with an organization, was the day we got to know that we were on the family way. So I had to push that travel and request them for a WebEx kind of a session. The day I delivered was a great day. It's going to go down in the history, which was 8th November 2016, the day of demonetization. So my daughter chose to come into the world on a day where, again, had some finance relevance to it. And as soon as she was born and she was a cesarean, I had my phone with me because my mom wanted me to listen to some holy songs. And sheer out of habit, the phone rang and I took it without even realizing. I thought it was my husband calling me. And I took the phone and I didn't even realize. And when I heard the person's name, it was a client of mine. And her first question to me was, so, you know, how are you doing? Is everything okay? When is the baby coming? I said, I just delivered half an hour back. And she actually screamed at me that, are you crazy? You know, why are you talking to me? Put the phone down. You need to rest. So I was like, no, it's okay. You know, I'm fine. And then there were a couple of other pending transactions because she was planned to be delivered on the 10th of November. But because of certain reason, we had to do it earlier. So work was pending and it had to be done. But anyway, after I got a bit of a thrashing from my family members that you please keep your phone on the side. So while I was with her when she was born and she reached about 18 months, I saw a bit of a creative flair in her.
Okay.
And I always wanted to be a mom who doesn't just teach, but who's able to mentor the child, who can bring in hands-on, do it yourself kind of activity. So I used to give her the paint and the brush, and I saw the way, you know, she would move the brush, the strokes that she had, and invariably she would pick up art and craft over anything else and books, then gradually puzzles and everything. So from there we started making handmade cards, you know, where I would engage her, we would make crafting, and I was zero in it. I used to hate all these things. I was never the crafty or the artistic person. And my mother, I think, tried hard, but she could not get that in me. And eventually, it's my daughter who, got me to get into some art and craft. And that's when Vanya's Craft was born. But Vanya's Craft was born from a perspective that whatever a child is doing, let's tell the world so that other children or parents also know that, you know, you can evolve your child by a lot of these activities. And then in one of the exhibitions, I just used those cards that she had made to decorate my stall, which I was, manning for my mother. And one after the other, those cards, somebody came and asked me, oh, they're so beautiful. So I told them that my daughter has made. So they said, okay, we want to buy it. And there were, I think, about 14 cards. All of them got sold. And that's when the journey started. And then maybe people like them and they asked me that, okay, can you create something for our occasion? And I was like, okay. So we tried that. We were able to do that. And I think then, of course, it's continued. And now we've reached a point that from making 2-3 cards to having got our biggest order of 365 handmade cards. And, we got first 20, then we reached 80. Then GWC also gave us a order for the Women's Day cards, and then we got 100, which was the highest. And I think breaching 100 led to 365. And it's been absolutely overwhelming. The smile on that child's face, that wow, you know, we have to make those cards, is, it really gives me happiness that whatever I did for her, I'm, reaping the benefits out of it from her nurturing. And every time we get an order, we use the proceeds to buy stationery for children who come from humble background, which she then gives it to them. So in order to teach her that sharing is caring, because she being a single child, it's very important that we teach her this concept that you have to share, and you have to earn to share, you have to learn to earn, and you have to learn to share. So, we want her to be a Santa for many and more.
That's really amazing. Being a financial advisor, as you run this program, Women Drink, for women entrepreneurs, so we would really like to know, what are the highlights of this program? What exactly the women will get to learn from these programs?
Okay. Honestly, Akansha, so one is Womentoring and the other that I run is called FinMentoring. The only difference between Womentoring and FinMentoring, first let me highlight the differences. There's a lot of myth breaking. For right. women to realize that one share a lot of live examples for realize that how important it is to understand investments and these situations that I share with them, the examples that are highlighted are not created. These are real examples of people who I have engaged, interacted journey to kind of assist them in executing whatever they want to achieve. What this program primarily does is it gets you to build a foundation. You will know about investments, the more you will know about your goals. So the program does understanding of
So there might be some network issues, so no worries. We'll wait for her because she may join in. So ladies, this talk show, GWC talk show, the line to it is aspire to inspire. We try to bring inspirational stories every Saturday on this platform because we believe that if you think, you can really achieve. And we want you to get inspired from these stories, these women that are doing very well in their lives, in business and in their lives too. So any such story, if you come across any such story, please connect to us and we'll definitely would love to share the stories with you all on this platform. So we have Ekta Sehgal Malhotra again.
Sorry, some technical.
Yeah, I was telling the audience. Yes,
so what
please.
I was sharing is that there is a lot of myth breaking. There is a lot of basic concepts so that the foundation gets built for people, be it a man or a woman, because the mentoring is more for women and the subtle difference is about myth breaking. Share live examples for people to realize how important it is to embark on that journey of investment. 2020, right. Starting March, a lot of people realized that wish they were better planned because nobody knew that the pandemic is going to come. And, you know, with the credit card in place, with easily available loans, a lot of us achieve our wants, our desires by taking loans without realizing that you are enjoying all of that, but there is a point in time where you need to repay it, for which you forget to budget. So all these things are highlighted for people to realize there are a lot of hard-hitting facts that those examples you know, tell you. And once they understand it, then it kind of triggers a thought that, yes, I need to embark on the journey. And the endeavor through this program is to reduce the number of financially illiterate people in India. Because as of now, the statistics is very, very, you know, poor. 76% of the Indian adult population is financially illiterate. And there are only 8% of the people pretty much world over who achieve their goals. So if that be the case, I think it is very important for a lot of us to really enhance our acumen with regards to finance and learn about ourselves, our risk-taking capacity, our goals, our objectives, do our budgeting. Only then will you be will you be able to sustain any volatility, any challenge, any pandemic that may come your way, and always have that smile on your face. So I think that is what these programs intend to. And Akansha, now we also do these weekly sessions on our page for people to understand. We've just started them about 3 weeks back. And Manas Management believes that education needs to be imparted. And the more people read about it, the more people know about it, the more people would embark on this journey. And hopefully, whenever a tough situation comes, you will not have to touch into your core portfolio. Because I have seen houses being mortgaged and eventually gone because of lack of money, because of any eventuality coming in. Ladies being completely clueless as to how and where the money was, how to manage that after the demise of the spouse. Or children clueless after parents, or father not being there. So, I understand ki kehte na moh maya nahi karna chahiye, ki jo bhi hai aap log saath leke nahi jaate ho, but jo reh jaate hain, they need to live their life. So if they need to live their life, then you need to be interested in this. And more so women, they really need to understand, because men find their way to manage all these things. Women find it very difficult when they reach at, because they're already under grief. And then if somebody comes and questions them, अच्छा ये पेपर्स कहाँ है, वो पेपर्स कहाँ है, यू देन रादर देन ग्रीविंग यू विल पार्डन मी बाय सेइंग दैट बट यू विल अब्यूज द पर्सन हु हैज गॉन बिकॉज यू आर लेफ्ट इन अ स्पॉट एंड मेनी अ टाइम दिस हैपेंस दैट द इवेंचुअलिटी डजंट नॉक एट योर डोर एंड से दैट हे यू नो व्हाट आई एम कमिंग So if that is not going to knock at your door, so you know that you've got to be prepared. And the youngsters today use credit card just like this, flash it around without realizing that that credit card also needs to be paid up. So all people, be it young, old, do plan your investments. Otherwise, we really need to think.
Right. That's absolutely right. So, as they say, don't be afraid to make mistakes and see them as an opportunity to learn. What is that piece of advice would you give any aspiring female entrepreneur listening to you?
Don't give up. No matter what. If you fail, very good. If you again fail, more, even better. And when you fail, you will learn that you are actually moving forward and there is so much of learning in it. So let the FA be the forward approach and IL be the intelligent learning that you get from all those failures that you have, because that's when you will actually be successful.
That's so beautiful. And even I believe that not attempting is failure. But if you attempt something and you fail, that is not a failure, that is an experience that will help you in nurturing your future projects or ventures or your future ideas. So, ladies, if you think something, try with your hard work and dedication towards that and give your best to fulfill that. So, ladies, as we have already shared about Ekta Sehgal Malhotra, she is the founder and managing director of Manas Management Advisors, who have these two programs, Fin Mentoring and Womentoring, specially curated for women, so that women can take care of their finances on their own without depending on anyone and be independent. Also, she runs M-Cube and Kiro Mentoring along with Vanya's Craft. Vanya Crafts is all into quilt cards, beautiful cards and tags and paper bags. So if you want to gift your loved ones, you can always connect to Vanya's Craft. So last not least, but any inspiring line that you would like our women to keep them with, always with them, so that they can get inspired every time when they just remember those lines.
जब स्कूल में छोटे थे और थक जाते थे फिजिकल एक्सरसाइज करके पीटी करा के, तो स्कूल का जो हमारा जो टीचर था वो हमेशा बोलता था कदम बढ़ाए जा, कदम बढ़ाए जा, मंजिल के नजदीक तू जाएगा. सो आई वुड से दिस, कीप वॉकिंग, और इवन जॉनी वॉकर्स लाइन, कीप वॉकिंग, बिकॉज व्हेन यू वॉक यू गेट क्लोजर टू योर मिशन, एंड यू नो, एंड एज यू गो क्लोजर टू योर मिशन योर विजन इज क्लियर and you will achieve all that you want to, because the journey is yours, the path you have chosen, so why blame someone else? So keep walking and enjoy that journey.
Lovely, awesome lines, and I'm sure many women who have joined us, they're going to be inspired from these lines. So we have Shweta Rai, who says, Ekta Sehgal Malhotra is an expert mentor for financial services. Yes, we know that, and we are sure, and definitely we all ladies are going to take benefit, and we are going to connect to her to take that mentoring and mentoring session, because we all need that. So let me see the other comments. Poonam Saxena ji, she agrees with your points that you shared over here.
Thank you, Poonam. Thank you, Shweta.
Thank you, Ilya. Thank you so much. So we had 9 people who joined us. So people, every Saturday we bring such inspiring stories like Ekta Sehgal Malhotra's. So to encourage us to bring more such stories, please share the video as much as you can, because the idea is to inspire many women through these stories. Because every woman has the same struggle, same share of struggles as a mother, as a wife, as a sister, as a daughter. Once they listen to these stories, they definitely get inspired. Let's set examples for each other and let's work together and grow together. Till then, take care. And next Saturday, we'll be again with one more interesting and inspiring story with you all. Thank you, everyone. Good evening. Thank you, Ekta Sehgal Malhotra.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me. Take care.
Bye. Take care.